For our discussion tonight, we're joined here in the studio by Department of Public Works and Highway Secretary Rogelio Singson. You can send us your comments and questions through Twitter using the hashtag PrimeTime or post them on our Facebook page, ANC247. Secretary Singson, good evening to you. Thanks for joining us tonight. We're going to try to and cover as much as we can because you're so busy. It took us, I think, a month, 2 months to get you here in the studio. Okay, now, unknown to many, as soon as you accepted your appointment, you had already worked, or you began working on a master flood control plan.
That's correct.
How difficult was it to decipher everything to make sure that eventually we'll have this system in place?
Well, it took us a year to prepare the master plan for Metro Manila and Laguna Lake, because to us, that's important. No? It can't be just Metro Manila.
Of course.
Now, as a result of Ondoy, we decided to also include the Pampanga River system. The approach that we have been taking is to look at a river system, not isolated, not pockets. Because DPWH used to do flood control downstream.
Mm-mm.
But if you don't do anything upstream where all that water comes from, then it's going to be useless. In a few years, all your flood control structures will be damaged by excessive rainfall.
But what about the coastal areas?
That's
as
correct.
Well?
So, let me explain. There are several causes of flooding. No, you have the extreme rainfall that is no longer held by the watershed because you have the denuded watershed. No, and then the elevation drop from the upper Marikina River, Montalban, and so on, to the level of San Juan is so big, so huge, 35 meters. No? So, napakalakas ng bulusok ng tubig. No? And then you have a very limited carrying capacity of Pasig Marikina, so it overflows very easily. And then, of course, you have the catchment basins in the core Manila. Alam natin na pag umulan, these areas will be flooded immediately. You have España, you have Araneta, you have the Maysilo area in Mandaluyong, and several others. No, we call them core basins.
Right.
No? Now, aside from that, you have the low-lying areas. No, you have Malabon na Botas, which are already below sea level. So you have to address them differently.
Well, let's go back to what you said about the slope and the watershed, the denuded forest that we have there. Kaya ba ganun kabilis na lang ang bulusok ng tubig? Because you have that 35-meter, as what you said, slope, and also you don't have anything to hold the water anymore. That's why it's just so fast.
That's correct. So you need several interventions. You have to reforest, you have to protect, and just have a good watershed management. But aside from that, what we're seeing is we need to contain that amount of water that is coming down. No? So we're looking at a dam to hold as much as 2,700 cubic meters per second that comes down during a rainfall event. No? So that you don't allow all of that rain to come down. And you can also use that for some other domestic use, no, for water supply. Now, aside from that, we have seen that there are natural catchment basins upstream, Montalban, no, which is similar to areas like the swamps. No, those are what we refer to as natural catchment basins.
Okay. All right. Now, having said all that, where do you begin? Is it, I mean, do you go to the coastal areas first because they're the ones who are always affected, even if there are no rains, there are no typhoons, or do you begin upstream?
There has been in the past flood control measures and structures, no, like the Kamanaba. So we want to repair the damaged dikes. And it looks like because of the recent events where the storm surge were a lot higher than what was expected or how that flood control structure was designed, we need to raise it by at least another meter.
Okay. Right?
Aside from that, we're now trying to improve the carrying capacity of the lower Pasig and upper Marikina River by just putting these walls and dredging parts of that. If you go through Guadalupe, you will see that we have raised the walls and you now see linear parts.
Yes. No?
So we've recovered that. So that will continue all the way to upper Marikina.
All right. Now, how do you intend to do that? Last night, we had Valenzuela Mayor Sherwin Galchalian here, and then he did say that he had a meeting yesterday, and it was quite promising. He even said that we don't need a river commission anymore, because if you delegate it to the LGUs in partnership the DPWH and the MMDA, a lot of things can be done.
That's correct.
Now, you thought about that. Why don't you think that we need a third party to solve this problem about dredging, for example?
Well, we will definitely need the private sector in some of these activities, no? But we really need a full cooperation of the LGUs, no? And in the meeting yesterday, the agreement with Secretary Robredo, because our work is the tail end of the clearing operations, no? Aside from the watershed, the carrying capacities of the steros, waterways has been so limited and reduced because of illegal structures, sedimentation, solid waste, no? So we need the full cooperation of the LGUs to be able to clear so that we can do the engineering intervention. Mm-mm. Hindi kami makapag-dredge, we cannot improve the walls of this waterway so that you improve the carrying capacity if there are illegal structures there.
So yun muna yung napabalitang sinabi niyong blast.
I never
blast
said
informal
I know. Maybe out of frustration. But I was referring to the blasting that happened years back dun sa Pampanga River. No? Because, you know, what happened then was there were illegal fish ponds, no, on the waterway that prevented the water coming out very easily to Manila Bay. Mm-hmm. So, kung maso at martilyo lang gagamitin yan, kailan matatapos yan? Mm-hmm. So, they had to blast some of the dikes, no? And that was in that context. But no blasting, please. No blasting in the residences or illegal structures.
All right, but did you get a commitment coming from the LGUs that they will do their best to really clear the waterways? Because, you know, lives are at stake here, ultimately.
I know. So the agreement is Secretary Robredo will be issuing a directive to the LGUs that we have to clear the illegal occupants on waterways, and we agreed on where we will start. We will start at the mouth of the receiving body. The main receiving body in Metro Manila is Pasig Marikina.
Yes.
No, so San Juan River, for example, feeds into Marikina. Mm-hmm. Nangka River in Marikina feeds into the Marikina River. Mm-hmm. So dun dapat nag-uumpisa. Mm-hmm. And similarly, the mouths of the rivers and esteros that feed into Manila Bay. Mm-hmm. You have Marikina, you have Las Piñas, you have Zapote, you have the Imus River, no? So they have to start clearing this waterway so that you have a very good flow, no? And kung may mga core basins inside Metro Manila, it will be drained very quickly.
Mm-hmm. No? Mm-hmm. So kailan ho yan magsisimula?
Well, we have proposed a quick response fund of 5 billion to be able to start doing immediately. Mm-hmm. No? So it looks like we will be supported by the President and DBM here. No? Mm-hmm. Because, for example, otherwise we will not be able to address the Camanaba and the Valenzuela Obando if we still rely on official development assistance or foreign loans.
Yeah.
Dalawang taon before we can start, and I don't think it is fair to let people wait for 2 years before we do anything.
Mayor Sherwin Galchalian also disclosed last night that there is some talk about purchasing equipment for dredging, no longer outsourcing that to a third party.
That's correct.
And then probably maintenance can be outsourced?
Well, we've done our calculations. No? If we buy our own equipment, we will be able to save substantial amounts rather than contracting them out. No? And the LGUs can deploy so that there is regular maintenance of the waterways. Mm-hmm. No? Let's face it, these waterways have never been dredged, no? So it's heavily silted, and the carrying capacity, therefore, has substantially been reduced, no? So with the type of Helen or Ondoy, where within a period of 2 days, you get the average you get 2-3 times the average monthly rainfall in a period of 2 days, mm-hmm. those waterways are not going to handle them.
Mm-mm. And when do we start seeing these equipment being brought in? Have we ordered it already? What's the status?
DPWH has already ordered some of this equipment. So
per LGU, you're going to have. Well, and how does it look like? Is it one dredging machinery?
There are specialized dredging equipment that we already have in the country, but they're deployed.
No? Right.
We brought a lot to Pampanga because we need to clear the waterways.
Olonga, I think, purchased one for them.
Olonga po bought their own. Yeah. No? We have a lot in Mindanao to dredge the Mindanao rivers.
Okay.
No? So these are specialized equipment that crawl on their own on the waterways.
Okay.
No? And they have their own barge. They have their own motors. In other words, and they have different contraptions. No? We have first a suction, no, so that the sediments can be sucked and put into a barge mounted or on the sides. Mm-hmm. You also have grass cutters, because if you encounter water lilies that have hardened, mm-hmm. no, it's not easy to take them out. So you have the cutters in there. Mm-hmm. You also have backhoe mm-hmm. to take out the solids. No, mm-hmm. And then you have, they can also be used to hammer on pile drives, no, mm. on the sides of the river. So,
which makes one wonder, if we know how to do it and if we have the equipment to do it, why did we have to outsource it to that Belgian contractor for the Laguna League? And now we have.
I did not decide that.
I know. But then, had they talked to you, then we wouldn't have this case on our hands. So, you're going to put the LGUs in charge.
We are going to need to support each other. Mm. No. This is not rocket science. We've done it in Fort Bonifacio. Okay, what used to be a Fort Bonifacio reservation, when it rained, she had a good absorption. Mm-hmm. No, now because of urbanization, no, you had all these roads done, and then to aggravate it, you started putting in drainage pipes
right.
to collect all of that water. Mm-hmm. Now, if we had discharged all of that collected storm water into that tiny creek in Kalayaan, and EDSA would be flooded and the whole of Kalayaan.
Mm-hmm.
So what we did was we put a drainage or retarding basin.
Mm. Is that the detention facility?
Detention tank.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and this is the width of that is the width of EDSA, and 4 stories deep. Okay. So all the collected water is retained or retarded there first, mm-hmm. and then you pump it out slowly based mm-hmm. on the capacity of the creek. Okay, that's the beautiful Burgos circle that
right,
you see.
Right.
And on top is a garden, underneath is a detention tank.
Mm-hmm.
We can do this type of intervention in flood-prone areas.
We can, but you're going to have to uproot everyone.
No,
we won't.
Put a water tunnel underneath side streets. Right. So we will start executing.
You're tired of explaining.
A little patience here.
We will see everything.
A little patience.
But it looks like you also have a big challenge here, and I don't know, maybe you can confirm this, that you're having a hard time hiring engineers who have enough aptitude and enough intellect to make sure that these projects are done and completed.
No. I think that is a result of a question that was, how come our engineers cannot be promoted? No.
Mm.
And so I said, I've been trying to professionalize the DPWH, so we, aside from the regular civil service tests, we've given promotions tests mm-hmm. no, in DPWH. 3 components, technical, analytical capabilities, and management skills. So we've been giving this before they can be promoted. Unfortunately, people are not doing too well. No? So I said, okay, I'll give remedial for those who pass technical and analytical, because mm-hmm. to me, these are stock knowledge. Management, I can train,
mm-hmm.
but an engineer should have the stock knowledge of being an engineer.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So that's how I responded to the congresswoman who was asking, can you promote this person even if he did not pass? And I said, I'm sorry, I can't do that.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Otherwise, will continue the same old practice of political patronage and so on.
Well, let's talk about how you've been dealing with this stint ever since you accepted this this appointment. Now, of course, a lot of people have this image or perception, call it misimpression, if you will, of the DPWH, that it's really one of the most corrupt agencies and departments that we have here in the Philippines. How have you been able to deal with that? Have you been successful in cleaning it up?
It's unfortunate because there are many who want a good professional organization. Nobody wants to be in an organization that has this reputation. So I have been getting very good support from inside the organization. And they have really supported us. So even in terms of the implementation of projects, no, we have been quite successful this year. As early as the middle of this year, we've practically done 90% of our projects. So now we're really preparing for the 2013. And we said we even want to do better next year.
Okay, now, speaking of next year, earlier this year, we started rolling out the PPPs. And all the people were expecting it to happen last year, beginning of last year. But then now we're beginning to see it. With all these projects now lined up, the private sector, for sure, or will it have a part in this?
Well, they have been very supportive, and they want more. And the president has approved a three-legged skyway network already for Metro Manila. Now you have the one that leads to the airport terminals 1, 2, and 3, and then ends in Roas Boulevard and the Pagcor City. And then you have the South Luzon connector, and then you have the skyway that leads into central Metro Manila, leading to San Juan and Quezon City, you know. So you have this three-legged network of skyways, you know, that people can use to, instead of, you know, seeking out with the traditional EDSA and the congested streets at the ground level.
All right. Mr. Secretary, we do have to give some time to our online followers. They took some time out to post these questions for you. On Twitter, Mang Pandoy is asking, how are you, Mang Pandoy? Nice to see you here on air. He's asking, well, how long will the flood master plan take to complete? How will they ensure it will last beyond 2016? Daming tanong, Mang Pandoy. And have they factored in climate change?
Yes, we have factored in climate change, and that's why we have been upgrading our standards. No, we continue to increase capacities of our waterways. We continue the drainage. We're now building huge box culverts instead of the conventional reinforced concrete pipes that have been undersized. No, but again, we need the cooperation of the LGUs, especially in big developments. No, they should no longer allow direct discharge of their stormwater into the city drainage system, because otherwise our designs were not designed to handle all of that huge volume that is thrown into the city drainage system. Otherwise, we will continue to dig up these roads just to increase capacity of our drainage system.
Mm-hmm. It's never going to end.
It's never going to end.
Okay, the first part of Mang Pandoy's question is, will these last beyond 2016, especially if you're putting a lot of responsibility on these LGUs? I mean, they change every so often. And baka naman pagkapalit na ng mayor, tigil na rin yung...
Well, that's why we had decided to roll out a master plan that will go beyond 2016. And in fact, the master plan goes all the way to 2036. You know? But we just have to face the implementation. And that's what we're doing now. We're doing the prioritization so that we focus on the high impact that will address a much bigger population.
Okay, on to Dor Santiago. He says, Netherlands is below sea level, but it never gets flooded. What are they doing right that we can adopt here in the country?
Well, they do a lot of underground water tunnels and pumping systems. Mm-hmm. No?
Can we still do that?
Japan, we're in the same situation as Japan, Korea. Their solution is really looking at the natural catchment basins. No, if they don't have their favorite flooded areas would be tennis courts and underneath auditoriums. No, in other words, once the river overflows, it knows where to go. Okay, mm-hmm. It doesn't meander.
It doesn't find its way into holes.
It doesn't go everywhere. Mm-mm. They go to specific areas. As I said, if you go the facilities I've seen, normal tennis court, but on the sides you see berms, no levees, no matataas yung, and they have a pumping system. Mm-hmm. So pag nag-overflow in river, yung tennis court babahain, nobody plays when it's under typhoon. Mm-hmm. So okay. So and then once the river can take the additional volume, then it is pumped out. They have one huge, this is to me the biggest, $1 billion to take care of Tokyo's flood system. It's a 4.5 meter diameter, mm-hmm. and 4 kilometers long. Okay, so once that river overflows, mm-hmm. all of that excess water just drops into this huge water tunnel, which is about 40 stories below ground. Mm-hmm. Okay? So it just stays there. Mm-hmm. They don't use it for drinking. They don't treat it. They just hold it there and then pump it out as soon as the storm event passes by, and the waterways can then take that additional volume. Mm-hmm. So it's a controlled detention tank.
Mm-hmm. Okay, as we wrap things up, I want to take off from the question coming from Mom Pandoy, one of our followers. He did ask about climate change. Of all these projects, do we take that, or have we taken climate change into account? Because you know, it may not stand whatever is coming our way.
Well, that's definitely, we've taken that into consideration by increasing our safety levels. No, we are design standards in this major river system. No, is such that, for example, the most devastating event in a 2-day rainfall, as far as Marikina is concerned, it was Ondoy. Okay, mm-hmm. It's a 70-year return period. We're upgrading to a 100-year return period safety level. Mm-hmm. No? In other words, if another Ondoy happens in Marikina, we should be able to handle an Ondoy, even up to an event that is a 100-year volume. No, mm-hmm. The highest event over a 100-year period, we should be able to handle that. Mm-hmm. The same is true with the downstream rivers. No? So, yes, we are considering effects of climate change.
Mm-hmm. All right. Until the next time we see you, maybe in the next 2 months. After 2 months, we'll see you again, or maybe next year. you're so
busy.
You'll
still invite me. Yes,
of course we will. Of course we will. We've been inviting you since you went on board. We'd like to thank you.
Thank you.
DPWH Secretary Rogelio Singson, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.